Okay, I just heard from Luigi that I'm on. So, hello everybody. This is Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone because we're on the US version playing Harry Potter 1 All Wizard Cards. And before I explain further, let's just leave this no audio weird place and start the run. In 3, 2, 1, go.
There was nothing about the starry sky that night to suggest that strange and mysterious things would
So,
soon be
this
around.
is Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, and
An
yeah, it's an
unsuspecting
old
mortal
game, it's a
said,
broken
"A
game. Some
huge
of you saw
meteorite with a
it
giant
a little bit
astride
earlier
tumbled
tonight
down from the
when
clouds.
Flo ran any percent.
The
We
giant
will have a
meteorite
little bit
left a
slower
blinking
approach
black
of this
bundle
game
on the doorstep of
because we
Mammoth
kind of
Lair
have to
by the
route a
dragon.
little bit. We have to collect
Nestled in the
25 wizard
bundle
cards along the way.
was a baby.
And 17 of
Arion,
those are
the boy who lived.
hidden in different secrets all
For
over
the next 11
Hogwarts.
years, Harry lived
One
on
of them we get
step
in
with his
exchange for
teacher,
some
Mrs. Weasley.
collectibles, fire seats.
Until that fateful
Six of
day,
them we have to
he had
buy
sealed
for
a letter inviting
25 beans
him
each,
to
and the
attend
last we
Hogwarts
unlock if you
school,
collect
which
all the
barred
other
him wizardry.
cards and
Hagrid
defeat
denied him that
Voldemort and
honor,
have collected
but his
250
uncle knew
additional
he was to
beans.
do so.
So in total, we have to
Black
collect
Gringotts
250
wizard
beans
bag,
plus 6
Hagrid
times
convinced the
24
Scruffy
beans for
Fudge
the
from Vault 7 to
purchasable
fight him,
cards, which makes a
that
total
Hagrid,
of 400
whatever it
beans.
was, would be
There are not
safer
many beans in the
somewhere
game. I
else.
think they're about, I would say,
Soon
700,
after,
a little bit over
Harry caught the
700 beans in
Hogwarts
total
Express from platform
in
9
the
to
game.
Great
It can vary
Gorge
a little
and left
bit
the Muggle world far
because some of
behind.
them can be substituted by chocolate frogs, which gives you
Dumbledore
life
stood up.
energy. So if you're
In
low
his
on life
turn,
energy,
the corridor on the lower
the
floor is out of bounds to everyone who did
chance
not
is
wish to
higher that you
suffer
spawn chocolate
the
frogs. So
most
that's also not
acute
really
death.
accurate. So we start the game
Harry sat beneath a sorting hat,
in which we have to
feeling like he
collect
would not be chosen
400
for
beans and
Slytherin Hearts of
25 wizard cards
Gryffindor.
with a 2 minutes
Not
19 point,
Slytherin,
no,
eh?
2 minutes
Said the hat in his
17.9
ear.
seconds long unskippable cutscene. All the cutscenes in
Could
the
be great.
game are
It's all
unskippable,
here
so
in
we
my
have
hand,
to
and
figure
Slytherin will
out
help you on your way
a
to
few
Hogwarts.
ways to manipulate them, avoid them,
Then,
abuse them
well, if you're sure,
to make them
better
faster
on.
in other ways because they're not skippable. Hello, Mickey. Hello, Coffee. Hello,
Gryffindor!
Kamikaze. Hello, everybody in stream. So, what I first did when I entered this first real cutscene after the intro cutscene is I hauled backwards. And the reason I do this is because for some reason, then the camera movement
Welcome
gets
to Hogwarts
messed up. It
School,
gets a little bit
Mr. Potter
faster, and as a
Wizardry.
result,
I am Albus
the
Dumbledore,
whole length
your
of
headmaster. Now,
the
Hogwarts
cutscene
is full of
gets beat
secrets,
up.
Harry,
So the cutscene
so
gets a
search
little bit
behind
shorter, or
every
rather, the
door, but keep
moment
in mind, not all
that we gain,
secrets
where we
are
gain control
rewarding.
appears
Only
sooner.
this morning, I took a wrong turn and stumbled
I'm a
upon a
Snixo
room
too.
full of chocolate
Somebody wake
frogs.
Nixo, please.
But alas, when I returned, they'd been
So a
replaced
little
by
bit
a
about the
nasty
controls. The
horror of
controls are pretty janky in
firebrand.
this game. You can't strive for anything.
Now, up the
So what we
stairs
do
and
is we
off to your lessons.
get a
Be
little bit
late.
better movement by binding every control direction to two keys and pressing one or
Muggle
both
Weasley,
keys at
my
once
brother's Fred and George,
to get,
Harry's
for
sidekick,
example, a little bit
Colin
better
Baker.
mouse, a little bit better turning movement because Harry can't strife, he can only turn.
Follow
And he
me,
turns
Harry!
significantly faster if you have binded two keys to every direction.
Hello, Harry. We can show you how to get around Hogwarts.
No, Emily, we
I'm
have just
afraid you
started.
have a lot to learn. Follow us for a secret lesson. I'll see you later in Defense Against the Dark Arts class.
Just
Good
missed a
luck,
few
Harry!
cutscenes, and this is a tutorial. There's not much to learn here, just yeah, I spoiled it for you. You can climb, you can jump, you can collect beans.
We're going to teach you how to climb. Run to the bookcase and don't stop. You'll climb up.
So ledge grabs are
Bookcase with
terribly long
Vernon's
this
Every
game.
Flavor Bean.
So what we
Collect
want to
all
do
the beans
is
you can
avoid
find
as
and
much as
collect them in the next room.
possible or get them shorter. For example,
Ah,
if I jump like this, except of climbing, the climbing animation gets much shorter. Also, you can get something like an instant ledge grab. This can be done with precise movement, like you just saw. And we have to collect the beans along the way, as I said, because, well, we have to buy wizard cards. We have to have a certain amount of wizard cards in the end. The game and title haven't changed, by the way. Luigi, please. Yeah, I think I can't do this some more, but I saw Luigi should do it. Alright. So, what I just did, this is Peeves. We just avoided him. And actually, in the cutscene with Peeves, I can move. And ideally, you want to move to this balcony over here, but this is only achieved to precise movement. And yeah. I must admit, I don't have it. So a cutscene is coming up, but we want to avoid it, so we just walk around the trigger. Walk around this corner as well, and we have to collect 25 beans even in any percent, because Fred and George won't let us move forward if we don't collect them. So as I said, jumping into ledges is most of the times much faster than climbing into them. This is special thing called multitask, because I ledge grabbed into the climb scene, the game gets confused and I can move inside the cutscene now, which gives me advantage. I have to wait a little bit until I pick up this wizard card, which I can inside the cutscene because I tricked the game, and this saved like 5 to 6 minutes. If I don't wait until this exit opens, yeah, the basically soft lock. And I'm pretty happy that I got this trick. This is pretty neat. This is even more neat in any percent. Oh, oops, I forgot to deactivate my split sounds. Yeah, I just got a gold split. Ahem, that was not planned. Yeah, maybe I shouldn't split. At least if I'm getting a gold split, I shouldn't. So this is Malfoy, he's a mean boy. We can just... No! No, 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 no! Okay, I was supposed to walk around Hermione and skip the cutscene, and yeah, I think this is not PBA anymore. I was supposed to avoid this cutscene. This was... Yeah, this was not good. Wow. Watch my wand. Let's skip the splits, is what I did. Yeah, this is what I'm gonna do, I think. Release the button when you're done. I mean, my PB is not really optimized, so I can still PB, but yeah, this is gonna make it hard. So what we have to do here, this is pretty awful in... Well done. We have to draw with the mouse the symbols. We have to do this once to get the 50% or the game won't proceed. And there are follow-up challenges that we don't have to do. They just give us additional points, but we don't need points. They just waste our time. What shape was that, Mr. Potter? Excuse the mistake as you being excited about the glot. Now, the excuse is it's a marathon run. These are the things that happen at marathon runs. And actually, I'm even not much behind PB pace now, because my I got the multitask. So that was pretty good. HP 1 all spell drawing Sven. I did it, it's called 100%. You can also do a meme category called all horse points, because you get horse points to spell drawing. And then you can do just that, but this on its own would be an awful category. So we just got the next tool we can cast at... we can cast with the left mouse button. It's so meta! Actually, when a tool is meta, it's bad. So yeah, you can say it's... Oh, it's so cool because it's meta. No, when it's in tool, it's actually bad when it's meta. Knock it over, Mr. Potter. Yeah. So we already knocked this one out over, we came before him, and now we can skip the entire puzzle here which can save about 25 seconds, and I messed it up. So the idea was to jump over the ledge there, which I can do. So I have to walk the whole way around because I messed up the split, sadly. The skip, I mean. Thanks for that, Kamikaze. Yeah, I knew it was the 143, I didn't know which how many seconds. So yeah, we lost about 20 to 25 seconds because I had to walk around instead of just skipping directly on the ledge. I'm missing a bean? Oh, there it is. Okay. So every time there is like a little not smooth underground, like a slope or something, I try to jump to get a super jump which can boost me forward. As a 2001 PC game, this game is full of glitches. One of them we have already seen, it's multitask. Another one is speeding up this camera movement for some reason when walking backwards. There's another way to speed up camera movement, it's basically the same. You're tricking the game into believing that you're walking backwards. By actually walking forwards, it's a little bit weird. So, next tutorial section just got introduced into save books, and we just proceed with this predetermined mechanic here. And we must not forget to collect beans along the way. For example, those beans and those beans. Okay, another neat technique in this game are hyper jumps. I try to attempt them, I'm really bad at them. Basically, you can get a little boost when you are walking up a slope. I just messed them up. Maybe I can get it now. There we go. That was a hyper jump. You can walk to the left and be about 3 seconds faster, doing a nice little skip, but it's pretty risky and I don't want to do it in a marathon. So the main glitch in HP1, HP2 is the menu glitch brightness boost. Better to say, menu glitch is for HP1 only. So what I do is, first I overlay the options menu over the pause menu. Now I have to wait for a sound trigger. And then what I can do every time I click on the brightness slider for some reason, so every time I change the brightness, Heavy gets a little boost when he's in a ledge grab animation or when he got damaged before. So I can actually stack this boost by unpausing and pausing again multiple times and in between clicking the brightness slider. Oh no! How did I mess this up? This was not what I was supposed to do, okay. So deaths are pretty much unforgiving, we were introduced into the mechanics of save books earlier. Thank you. And you can't save manually, you can only save at save books. That's unbelievable. That's unbelievable. Oh, come on. Oh, come on. Because your name is Raman? Yeah, that makes sense. That makes total sense. I just wanted to show off this beautiful brightness boost. We will see it several times throughout the run because it's, of course, not the only location where it's useful. What is... I have no words. Yeah, this is a marathon, I realized. Okay, once again. I just wanted to show to you how it's not done. Now I show you kinda how it's done. I'm so sorry. I mean, we are a little bit ahead of schedule, right? And yeah. I didn't want to cause more unnecessary breaks, so I messed up the timing this time, so I didn't go for this one. I'm still on PB pace, by the way, because as I said, my PB is not really optimized. So timing is really important in this section. I think Flo said earlier, Flipendo is the hardest part. Oh yes, Liam, you have to run after me, I forgot that. It's the hardest part in the run, and especially if you do advanced strats. Knock him on his backside to complete the challenge. They move quickly and can be quite a nuisance. So gnomes are really bad. I want to get rid of all the gnomes along my way, because gnomes can actually steal my bones. And my beans. And the bad thing is, unlike in HV2, they don't give them back to you. So they're gone forever. And now question, if someone were to get a new PB of new World Record Tuna Marathon like this, would it be updated to the leaderboards? Well, it's actually not a problem, because most of the marathon ones, and these ones again as well, are stored on Twitch. And all you have to do is provide video proof, right? And if you have it, it's of course legit. And so of course we have a video here, so yeah. And this happened today. We got a world record today, actually, in Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets for 6th gen, meaning Xbox, PS2, GameCube, done on Xbox. And yeah, this might or might not be submitted, because it was only a 2-second record, so maybe Starlight will not submit it, I don't know. This is flying. Flying is awful in this game. It takes a long time to get used to it. And actually, my first run, I didn't even get all the rings, so I didn't even have to bother. And we must not forget, we still have to collect wizard cards, and yeah, there's a wizard card on this flying cross. Pretty mean, but yeah, that's how it is. Oh, I didn't know I got that ring, nice. I can't really reach chat at this moment, because this is tense. This requires all my focus and concentration. So there's not much to say to it. So the perfect way is of course to break as rarely as possible, and it's pretty it can pretty much be done with only one break throughout the flyings. Flying is best in this game, Raman's lying. I mean, it's kinda neat when you get used to it, but until then it's pretty bad. I'm sorry. Congratulate you for being the first student to find the secret room since 1867. From now on, you may practice flying at any time. You will find the option. Emily, what I'm actually doing, I'm having time for your charms lesson now. Good day, Mr. Potter. That was an exceptionally good flying. Wow. At least my timer says so, which is weird because I almost missed the ring. So what I'm doing is I'm streaming from another channel right now, which gets resumed by Potterthon, and on this channel I actually have my timer present. So if I would get a PB, yes, it's still possible somehow, then I could use this video to submit with the loadless timer. So yeah, the next spell we learn is the most useful for us, Alohomora, because among other things, it enables us to cast on magically enchanted chests, and these magically enchanted chests often contain beans. And we want and need beans. And it's the same game as before. We do the 50% challenge on the next one, we just fail. Great wrong skills. I have problems with Alohomora recently, I don't know why. The funny thing is, I also ran 100% of this game, and in 100% you have to actually complete all the drawings, and the last challenge requires you to get a 95% accuracy on spell drawing. This is borderline impossible in some spells. It's especially hard in Alohomora and also in Wingardium. Most of the ones die to spell drawings. Most of the ones in 100 due to the old set used to die due to forgetting chests and spell drawings. But yeah, Hundo is not an hard category, it's mostly about memorization. And yeah, what mostly, where most runners fail is drawing, spell drawing. So we casted these knights not only to get beans, but also to reveal a secret inside of a secret, this one. This can also only be done if we cast four times at both guards. Get these beans as well. I would have gotten a gold split, by the way, as well, here. So this was pretty good movement. I'm happy with that. By the way, the lines which with the teachers validate or review our drawing skills also are pretty much RNG. They are a little bit dependent on how high your percentage is, but there's also RNG involved. Oh my god, this was beautiful. Beautiful drawing skills, and I barely got over the 50%. So the only thing hard to learn is you have to learn the brightness boost, which is actually not hard, so this is good. And a few tricks, which are also kinda okay to learn. And then you have to remember the route, This is basically what you have to do for Hundo. So the route and the memorization of the route is of course the hardest part. Follow me, Mr. Potter. Our wizard cards is kinda hard regarding tricks you have to do. This is kinda like 100% light because it's the 100% category with a little bit less not fun parts like spell drawings. Spell drawings cost about, I don't know, 6 to 8 additional minutes. We can do another pot jump here, but this one is easier than the first one, so I definitely shouldn't fail it, and I didn't. In the background of this room we have a lot of bean opportunities, so we will use them to our advantage. There are beans, there are more beans, and more beans! It's so sad that there's no bean bonus room in Harry Potter 1. We do this puzzle really quickly. I like to do it glitchless, which means we do it just intended with these blocks. One of these blocks you can actually clip through the walls, but it's kind of hard, and sometimes it can cost much more time than it saves you. Because it actually doesn't really take long time to do this. Just cast a few times Flipendo, wait for the gate to open, and that's basically it. It's like 5 to 7 seconds time lost. Maybe I can show you a super jump now. Yes, that's a super jump, a beautiful run. So because there was a rough change of underground in the environment, at exactly when you jump at exactly the right frame, you get boosted forwards massively. And if this game, as this game runs on 60 FPS, the frame perfect trick is not really that easy. That was really a lovely super jump because it maneuvered me right to into the gate where I wanted to go, to the exit. So there are a lot of ledge grabs here and we want to avoid them, and the easiest way to do this is of course by stacking ledge grabs. It's not really stacking, we just do this brightness boost as often as possible. Like I said, with pausing and unpausing and in between clicking the brightness slider while being in a ledge grab animation. Okay, we can skip this cycle from this really slow moving block that is here over the bottomless pit by just standing here, jumping from here and jumping across of it. This saves a lot of time. Now Flitwick is awaiting for us. We are not so keen to meet him, so we just skip the cutscene with him by randomly casting at the end of the classroom. And wow. This was a nice level. This was a really nice level. You must not forget the beans. So this level is just an intermission level. The intermission levels are kinda interesting in not any percent categories, because there's a lot of writing to be done here. Because the intermission levels are not linear mostly. And this is actually the level with the most wizard cards. There are 3 wizard cards in this level. And in most of the other areas, there's either no wizard card or 1 or 2. So here's a peeve fight coming up. We don't want to fight peeves, so I try to skip it, and I managed it first try. That's nice. That was peeve skip. Clapper, clapper. And yeah, like I said, some of these cards we have to buy, like the very first card in the game, which showed Orbis Dumbledore. And we have to buy this card as well.
Here's a wizard card then. Hope you don't have this one yet.
Hello, V-Man. Why shoutouts to me?
Thanks for helping us out, Harry.
I'm glad you missed the beginning of this run. So these animations are also... These animations when he picks up the wizard cards are kinda strange. I mean, they're beautiful, but you don't even have to try to mess them up most of the times. Like, they look really glitchy and Harry levitates from the ground. This switch gives us a little bit more beans.
Hey, Potter, do you like surprises? Malfoy's got a present.
Feisty threats are actually really interesting, that's true. But they're also pretty hard because you can't... we will come to that later, but basically you are aiming with your wand blindly, and this can be kind of hard and kind of hard to predict. It's pretty consistent. This part in any percent is the most fun part in the level, in the game, at least in the any percent run. And if you know kind of what to do, it's actually kind of consistent and kind of easy to do and kind of fun. You can still mess it up though, even if you're experienced. Harry, please cast. So this brightness boost, as you might have realized by now, is pretty useful. Especially if there are climbing parts so that we can just entirely skip with this. I try to land on the corner of the mirror here, nice, like this, so that we skip the ledge grab. And now we have to fight Malfoy. Oh no!
Well, well, Potter. we meet again. Having a tour of the castle, are we? This is as far as you'll be going. You won't get past me, no matter how hard you try. Oh, boo-hoo!
I like this catch tree, and I also like the old 100% mainly because we explore all the beautiful secrets in Hogwarts, and that's basically what the game was for as a child. So we don't would want to fight Malfoy, so we just skip him. This would have been another Bogart split, by the way, which I had to skip. Dang it, I should have deactivated the gold sound.
Hurry, over here.
This was pretty good level. For me.
Hello, Harry. It's me, Hagrid. Good to see you. These are the Hogwarts.
This cat is basically beans percent. Well, I mean, 100% is also beans percent. This is basically a friendly 100%, like a more forgiving 100% without spell drawings and stuff. There's a nice little secret here with the chests. It gives us a few beans. Thank you so much, Kitten Impossible. I'm glad you enjoyed.
The herbology lesson is just past Professor Sprout's garden. I'll wait here for Neville. I think he's got lost again. Go on, Harry. You better.
As mentioned, there are so many cutscenes in this game, you can't really skip them. This train gives us a little bit more beans.
Nintendo, Nintendo.
And we have to go to Herbology. We just heard for the third time from Hermione that we have to go fast. But this is what we are doing through the entire game. We are going fast, but we also have to embrace our joy in collecting wizard cards, right? Okay. We skip this part easily with brightness boost because you can't only brightness boost if you are in a ledge grip animation, you can also brightness boost when you get damage. We will use this once more to skip this entire maze, or almost the entire maze. We don't want to skip it entirely because there are some neat little beans around the way which we want to collect. This should be it? Yeah, nice. Now we can just walk over the maze, that's the old maze fix. Guys, if you're ever stuck in a maze, just climb onto the hedges. That's how you escape the maze. That's the manual, basically. We can't cast at those or these plants, but we can avoid them by jumping. So there are two cards in this level, and they are both at the very end at the level, right before we enter the classroom.
Hey, Harry. Have you collected 24
also, the music in the background is a little bit slower than it normally should be. This is the Fred and George theme that you hear.
Come on, George.
This happens sometimes. I think it's only if you play it on modern PCs. I don't remember it from my childhood that the music got glitched. So I probably recognize this fellow, this is Godric Gryffindor. Also, all the music is composed by Jeremy Saul, like for almost all the Harry Potter music. So the secret is right behind this hedge. We would normally have to walk around it, but we are lazy, so we just take a little shortcut. We would have to walk around the entire greenhouse normally. I mean, maze is waste time. Why would we attempt to do mazes? And let's make it back as well. Nice, like this. Exactly like this. Collect a few beans. This would have been a gold split as well. Wow, what is going on today? And this after the terrible beginning.
Today we learn the incendiary spell, which is useful against all manner of dangerous plants.
Yeah, that was nice. Normally I take a few tries for this hedge skip, and today I got it first try, which is pretty nice. Both ways first try.
The pattern, then release the button.
This looks very complicated, this spell, but it's actually, because it's complicated, I think it's also pretty forgiving, so I can just squeak a little bit over the shape in general and still get 80% and perform an outstanding incendio, as my lab sprout says. Hello, Vitaly. And like always, we failed the second one. This is the last spell drawing we are doing in this game.
It's not incendio.
Rip. This is PG-13. Also, this is an onion. You could clearly see it was an onion. Come on. This is the onion spell. We all know it.
Through the doors, Mr. Potter. I'll watch you from the balcony. Those are spiky bushes. You may cast incendio on them. But step back to avoid their needles.
So this is pretty straightforward. We have to defeat those gnomes to proceed. And now we do this quirky little thing where we trick the game into walking backwards by not actually walking backwards, speeding up the cutscene and doing another multitask like we saw at the beginning by deliberately getting hidden by this plant right when we trigger the cutscene by defeating the plant. We can just move inside the cutscene again. That's a nice multitask. We can skip this entire level by casting multiple times. I messed it up. Multiple times at the same Flippendo tile. Normally you what you should have done is you had to cast Flippendo at every one of those bookshelves once. Or better to say Alohomora once. And then Flippendo on the tile to bring it back. And we just did 4 times Flippendo at one bookshelf and had the same effect. By the way, the wizard card you just saw was the wizard card of Newt Scamander from Fantastic Beasts, the author of Fantastic Beasts. We can skip this entire room with the cutscene that we normally would trigger. There are more beans. We tried to get rid of those toxies, or to at least avoid these toxies. You can skip this tree level. There's actually a faster way to do this brightness boost by reloading the game while it's running. Oh, this is the wrong way. I need the chest over here. I forgot the chest, almost. Okay, let's defeat the gnomes first, because gnomes are nasty in this category. This chest gives 8 beams, so it's worth the detour. So normally we would have to solve a puzzle in the room to our right, but we can just skip the entire puzzle by casting through the grate. And this is the second part of Incendio, because Incendio is apparently such a big level that it has to be divided into 2 parts by loading screen. You have to do a little detour here to just proceed intended around this little plant here to trigger the mechanism to proceed. This is also part of any percent. Okay, there's a little chest here. Just collect the beans. I don't really like this room because of its weird hitboxes. We just triggered 2 cutscenes at once, which is nice. Which means Heavy can move a little bit faster, and also both of the cutscenes play at once. So this is also a kind of multitask. So to proceed there, we have to climb up this tower thing on the right. And I'm not really good at it, but I'll give it a try to glitch my way up the tower, kinda, in 2 steps. Yeah, 2 steps is safer. Hello, Harry? Thank you very much. We are not done here. We because there's a chest here with a lot of beans, and we want those beans. So, if you have noticed, we have seven children stars by now, which is weird because we shouldn't have so many. The reason is that we didn't lose our challenge stars from the Wingardium challenge, because we skipped the Flipper cutscene. So normally we would go through this entire maze, then go up the maze, and then go the entire maze back. We can just skip this by damage boosting up here. Which is neat. And open the gate from up here. So previously to the first part in this game, we can just cast four times on this Flipendo tile instead on every Flipendo tile once. Oh, another super jump, that's great. And we can skip here the final cutscene as well. And this would have been another gold split. So this was Incendio. We just skipped the ending cutscene with Sprout by just walking around here.
Best to discuss it back at my hut. Meantime, you're gonna be late for your broomstick training. Off you go.
So normally you could also be able to skip the Hagrid cutscene, but this involves hyper jumps and I'm not good at hyper jumps. Now coming up are a lot of cutscenes.
Quite upset. Best go and see what he wants.
Please help me.
You should continue your practice, Kamikaze. It's worth it. It's fun in the end to run it. It's really, because of all these tricks, it's really hard to learn this game. But when you run it in the end, it's pretty fun.
Think you can catch me? Come on then, Potter. Give me back Neville's Remember All, Malfoy. You want the Remember All back?
So, Malfoy stole Neville's Remember All and we're just getting it back, hopefully quickly. Just have to bump into him four times. And then for some reason we have to press jump. And while we press jump, it doesn't matter where we are. We can be as far away from Malfoy as we want. We still knock him down. So that's kind of a weird mechanic that you can pretty much abuse. And yeah, we got some weird textures in the back, this happens sometimes. I hope it will be fine within the next level. If you look at the bushes, they are on pretty low detail right now.
I remember now. I left Trevor near the herbology class. There are plants there that eat toads.
Mr. Potter. I'm Professor McGonagall, Deputy Headmistress of Hogwarts.
And like in the movie, we just got the message.
Although I do not approve of your chasing Malfoy about,
that
you have remarkable
talent on broomstick, and therefore we can start as a seeker in playing Quidditch.
In your case, we might overlook.
We skip the Quidditch training, by the way. We just get a tutorial at the end of the at the beginning of the match later. Oh, that's nice, right? Yeah, okay, you don't know what Quidditch is, you just got recruited to be in the Quidditch team and the first match is this afternoon and you don't have time to practice because you have to visit Hagrid for a cup of tea. That is what we are gonna do now. That's a nice little glitch you can do here. It's not exactly useful and also I didn't manage to get it. You can get a super jump here just by the loading screen. Oh. That was not intended. I apologize. But it doesn't really help you because the camera gets messed up. So what I'm trying here is to get a backwards ledge grab, which is not easy. And I also failed it. This was one of the hardest things, movement-wise, to learn for me, to get those backwards ledge grabs. And we can skip the entire level because there are wizard cards in this level, but there are two wizard cards and they are both at the end of the level. So we just go onto the map like I just did, go to the end of the level, skip the entire level and just collect the wizard cards at the end. That was the first one.
Incendio.
And the second one is here. There's also a chest. Nice. We can just walk through this bush while it despawns. That's nice. There's an invisible wall here, so you have to be kind of careful when you casted this chest, because you can hit the invisible wall and not actually casted it. We skipped three ledge grabs. No, we skipped two ledge grabs with the boosting here. Normally the boost only goes up, but because there's a ceiling that gradually goes up in these caves, you can actually also boost forward a little bit, and this is what I just used to my advantage. Oh no, spiky bushes! As you can see, we can just walk through them while they despawn.
Hurry. Over here.
So we just reached Hagrid's hut. Apparently he has a pretty hard way to reach his hut.
By the way, congratulations.
And now he sends us on a little mission. I really love the cutscenes in this game. Or I used to love them, of course. No, I kind of still like them, but of course nowadays they look a little bit outdated. But they're kind of chill, the music is nice.
It's a dragon's egg, Harry. But it's our secret, mind you. The egg is in a very delicate stage.
And we got introduced to Hagrid's little soon-to-be pet, the dragon, whose name is not known by now.
I grow them in caves out in the garden. I need you to collect as many fire seeds as you can find. Careful though, they're spitting fire and the seeds are hot. Let them cool down before you pick them up. Off you go then.
So we're gonna, normally we would not collect the fire seeds for him in any percent. We can just skip the entire level and he would still be content, which is a little bit weird. But the thing is, if you collect a certain amount of fire seed, which is 18, there are 21 fire seeds we could collect at max, and we will collect 18 of those. And if you collect these 18, we get an extra wizard card. And also in this level there's another wizard card on the way that we can collect. No bad. No spoilers, Pixel, please. So, normally I want to get rid of pixies, but this one I will let live, and this is pretty important. Because this doxy that we just let survive will give us a little gift in exchange. And this gift is called Doxy Storage. This means that now we can do a little bit hard to aim long casts. I try to show it off here. Like this one here. Normally I couldn't cast so long. And this will come in handy in this level. So, now we collect the wizard card, which is right here. So, the problem is to come up from the wizard cards. This would take a long ride time intended because there's this really slow elevator. So we do a little quicker way by again ledge grabbing backwards and stacking until we reach the top of the map and just walk to the end of this area. Done. So that was that. As you can see, there are very many very neat tricks in this game. And now our long cast comes in handy. Harry, please. Thank you so much. So we casted Flipendo on the plans before we enter the cutscene. Why is this important? This is important because the fire seeds need time to cool down. And because we... Because we collected... because we casted at the fire seed plan before the cutscene, the fire seeds could use the time to cool down during the cutscene. So afterwards, they were already cooled down. So we didn't have to wait additional time like we have to do now. Now we can't do anything, we just have to wait until the seeds cool down. And we can't pick them up when they are not cooled down. Yeah, this part could be pretty bad as a kid because there are many occasions where you can fall down and there are many mobs because these are the outside levels. This is was my hardest thing to get over with when I used to run glitchless in this game, the glitchless category, because the hardest thing for me in glitchless was to avoid the creatures, and the outside levels are full of creatures. When you compare this to HB2, in HB2 basically everything, every area, every level is loaded with creatures of any kind. Here it's just the outside levels, and these are therefore sometimes hard to route in terms of movement. Like this plan that got me because I got the movement wrong. By the way, I deliberately skipped the fire seed plan because, as I said earlier, we don't need all of the fire seed plants. We can skip one of the plant with 3 seeds and we will still have 18 in the end, which will be enough to get our final wizard card at the end of the level. Let's move around these plants a little bit. Now you could abuse long casts in this level. I tend to not use it because I have a kind of nice route to do it without long casts, and also I'm not really good at long casts, so I do it without. So I first casted the fire seed plant and then casted the pillars that I have to get down to proceed with the level, and then I get back to collect the fire seeds plants that have, oh my god, this snail, that have cooldown until this part. HP2 will be great. We have HP2 after this 100%, and this is pretty much the greatest run of all HP games. Why does the estimate seem wrong? It should be 150 or 155. I don't know what your estimate is. I can't see the estimate on stream right now because I don't have it open because I have poor internet. No, that's correct. 155 is pretty much correct. Yeah. Great work, Harry. I need the 155 because there are things to mess up. So actually 150 would also be sufficient, but I'm kind of worried because of internet issues on my end, so 155 is justified. And there's this wizard card that we got in exchange for 18 fire seeds.
Go ahead and put them in the fire, Harry.
So yeah. Yeah. Great, Luigi. Thank you for making sure. The funny thing is, in any percent we don't collect any of the fire seeds and we still trigger this cutscene, and Hagrid being so grateful for us collecting all the 0 fire seeds, and then the triggering hatching and all.
You'd best get ready for Quidditch now. Should be an exciting game.
I don't understand this mean to be so, to be honest.
We'd better give Norbert his first feed soon.
So for me, a hundo estimate would be more like 2 hours 5 minutes. 155 would not have been enough for me. Because 100% is pretty inconsistent. So now we get the whole rule set delivered by Lee Jordan, the commentator, who... flying levels in Harry Potter 1 are a little bit weird, because for some reason in those the sound fights can get pretty messed up. Like this. Like Adam said, time for a Quidditch, like this. This can happen for some reason in flying levels. Flying levels are weird. So broomstick training or Quidditch levels. So we try to collect this as quickly as possible. Should be not too slow. And wait until we have the snitch, and we have the snitch. Oh my god, Luigi, you're gonna die. Can't anybody else help you with the schedule, please? So you don't have to do anything on your own. Think this won't be too bad. Ravendor is also a pretty common sound bug that can happen.
Harry Potter, the youngest seeker in the history of Hogwarts, had won the Quidditch match.
Congratulations again for winning the Quidditch match against Slytherin. You are fantastic. Something is troubling me, Harry. Ron and I heard strange noises outside the Forbidden Corridor. Come up to the third floor and have a look.
So this level, I don't know the name, it's called Intro, just Intro in debug mode, even though it's not the intro. It's just the first indoor level after the big outdoor part. And in this part of the castle, we actually can't cast at anything, can't get any beans or whatever. It all begins here on this floor. For example, here's the base. So you might probably ask, haven't we been here before? Yes, that's... it seems true, but actually not, because every time you are like in these intermission levels, they're actually entirely different maps. Even if you are here in second floor landing, they might look the same, but they're different. They have different hitboxes, they have different secrets, different bean opportunities, different mechanics. Like Fred and George, you only have in this part of the Hogwarts intermission level.
We really needed these. They're for a little joke we're playing on Slytherin.
Probably need to be someone in Europe.
You've earned it.
Problem is, I could only start. I can't really be there at the beginning. That's a problem. That's pretty much the problem, because tomorrow morning I'm away, and tomorrow at lunch I'm also away, apparently. So we got the wizard card, that's all. That's all, folks. And yeah, the rest of the level consists of a very long cutscene and a long spell drawing thingy. And we don't want to have any of this, so let's just skip both of it, okay? Let's just skip it. Or let's at least try to skip it. So the first cutscene is an ominous cutscene with Snape. We want to skip it by just dragging the board a little bit. Almost triggered the cutscene, by the way. Harry, please don't idle around, please. Thanks. That was the first skip. And now we can skip actually Lumos spell drawing for some reason. It's possible, because there's a trigger which with which we can proceed to the to the Lumos Challenge. I just have to do it right. Just kinda have to align myself here. And there we go. And hello. Just go to the trigger and yeah, we skipped spell dwelling. That's nice. And now we can just proceed to the level. Yeah, SLS Onyxo would probably be up for that. That would be great.
Hold down the mouse button to aim the spell. To cast Lumos, let go of the button. You may practice on that.
So this is Lumos is a nice and fun level, but it's also one of the most difficult ones and one of the most unforgiving ones. At least for me, some of the tricks are pretty hard.
Cross the chasm and collect your challenge.
So this is Lumos, the last spell that we learn in this game. And yeah, it does not only make light, it makes light clouds. In HP2 it makes light secrets for some reason, which is weird. So we just grind a little bit beans. So we have to do a lot of unintended detours in all reserve cards for all the beans we need, and we'll be still a little bit short, at least on my world, just before the end, and then collect the last beans at the very last occasions. Because yeah, we need 400 and there are not so many bean opportunities that are not completely remote. I forgot about the bean, I will still take it. So yeah, we can kind of do a far ledge grab here with these clouds. This is also possible with blocks, but we mostly do it with clouds because but it's just because how we can abuse it. It's basically the same with blocks. It just happens that throughout the route we mostly do it with Lumos clouds. So there's one card in Lumos. I hear that pretty many people who played this game casually had problems to find this card. It's right here. I think it's card number 17. I haven't kept count, but I think so. Oh, I wanted to jump. Yeah. So, hello Flo, welcome to the stream. Yeah, that was this part, this card here, the card in Lumos. I was too far away, okay. I should memorize the point we have to send the cast at the Lumos statue, because we want to go back to this strange elevator cloud as fast as possible to do this neat skip here. Far edge grab again, and we can just skip the entire puzzle in this room and just warp until the end by abusing our nice brightness boost. And we're almost at the end. This is the last room. I mean, behind this door it just opens like this. And you have to do a lot of detours, a lot of cutscenes normally, but we will just skip all of this. Just jumping here unintentionally. If you want more beans. So I collect the beans. We have some steps here. Steps mostly mean super jumps, but yeah, of course I don't get them. We ignore this doxy deliberately. This is important again. And now we just warp ourselves, if it's possible, this is a hard trick, just to the end of the level. Oh, this could fail, this could fail, this could fail. This failed, of course it failed. Ah, didn't quite do it right. Okay, okay, okay. Like I said, I don't really like Lumos. I know that I'm also kind of slow. This, I'm not doing the wheel up boost, I haven't tried it out yet. So Wheeler Boost is slightly faster, like the thing I do with pausing and unpausing. Hello? Can you please boost, Harry? This might not work. Oh yes, this will work. This will work. This will work, yeah. Like I said. So we have the long cast, we just hit the secret trigger here. And we are done with Lumos. We need more beans. Again, another intermission level. Again, different spots, a different map, different Higgs boxes and everything. And one of the cards we again get from Fan and George. For some reason we can approach Fred and George slightly before the dialogue line ends. Just when he says experiments we can jump. Yeah, it can save about 20 to 30 seconds I think if you do all use Wheeler Boost, so not much, but if you're going for world record or really good times, it's of course a pretty nice method. So I go this way because there are more beans this way. Hello, attack. No, nobody banned reloads. That's fake news if you heard that.
Next is our potions lesson. And it looks like we're already late.
There are different people with different opinions, but at this point, reload boosts have not been banned. And here's the second secret candle, which is pretty mean. It's actually quite obvious if we just search the area a little bit. The problem is, there's one! Like always in the Harry Potter games, one is the problem. He's pressuring you constantly. No, we have to go to potions, we are late. And then you're like, okay, we just walk over here and exit here. And completely overlook the wizard card. And this is also the wizard card that has killed a lot of all wizard cards or 100% ones in the past of many runners.
Potions,
because it gets forgotten.
Today you will learn how to mix a Wigan Weld healing potion. You're late for potions, Mr. Potter. Inexcusable even for celebrities.
So this is potions. I hated this level as a child, but I really love it nowadays, because it's a nice platforming level, with of course bottomless pits, ooh, spooky, scary, and ominous music, but as a platforming level, it's pretty great, I think. So we can do another kind of a pot jump. We trick this game again into thinking that we walk backwards into a cutscene, which we don't really do, but yeah, it's kind of the same. Can do a nice glitch here. This is just for fun. Just walk backwards into the jump backwards into the potions classroom again. We can skip this entire block puzzle by just jumping onto this block, or better say boosting on this block, jump over here and we are done.
Martini told me.
And yeah, now the fun platforming begins. There's the card that we have to get here. Oh my god, I almost messed up this jump. This should normally not happen. Okay, I want to go quick here. I mean, really quick. Without messing up, because I want to catch a cycle with the platforms that are activated. Remember when I did them straight and ran through the middle anyway? I don't quite remember. I know that many people are struggling there. That was quick enough. I get the cycle, even with getting those beans which I need. Nice! I even got all of them. That's pretty helpful. Hello? Thank you so much, game. Yeah, I wanted to cast from here. The problem is these stones that we stand on, these platforms, they will fall down after some time, so I don't want to miscast too many times. So when I fed it once, I just work off the platform, or jump off the platform rather. And Filch is of course the level we all hated as a child and still hate even more to this day. And as you can see, we now have 12 stars because we still have all the stars from the previous levels except from the Flippendo level. So I'm casting at this dragon because this dragon has more beans. I have to get rid of all those. And this one as well. Did you steal my bean? You stole my bean! You little thingy. You should still be good on beans. There are more beans. Yeah, we're pretty good on beans right now actually. So you could do a block leap through the grates here as well. I never learned it. I heard it's kinda easy, but let's do this legit. It's not that long. Just do three little Wingardium casts, move the blocks around, and we are done. So now there's a big spooky room. If you hold forward, which we of course do as speedrunners at the big after the loading screen, we skip the animation of these platforms. Normally the platforms would move and mess us up pretty bad. I'm trying to get a backward sledge drop here to boost myself up and land here on this tiny ledge and then just skip this entire thing, or almost the entire thing, until we get here. And at the end of this room, we can skip the cycle of this moving platform by just jumping quick enough. I grab this save book for safety. Your family could do it in one go. Wow, your family was probably cheating or speedrunning. Because the good thing about the Voldemort fight is it's completely scripted, so once you know how to do it, once you know the exact movement patterns, it's pretty easy. I'm still pretty short on beans. I don't like this. Why am I so short on beans? So we can skip the cycle a little bit by jumping on to the platform here and also entering this entering this gate here, because there's another wizard card. Here, just like this. Yeah, the spell drawing is off on this game, and also the casting is pretty much good. Okay, it's pretty much hard. Oh, I forgot to cast at the chest. Normally I would have cast it at the chest before, I kind of forgot this. So what I probably didn't explain before was the mechanic of the Bloody Dragon, not Bloody Dragon, Bloody Baron, the host ghost of Slytherin that we can follow around and he can lead us to secrets. These are actually pretty neat secrets, because normally no child would come to think that he would follow the Bloody Dragon. Because he's spooky, don't follow him! Skipping ledge grabs, attempting a super jump. Not super jump here, sadly.
Late again, you lazy boy.
And when I was swimming casually, took my sister to finish it for me. Yeah, I mean it's a hard fight, so that's understandable.
But I'm afraid they have no value in my classroom. I've ended the lesson with.
Don't tell me this would have been Godspeed as well. Don't tell me this would have been Godspeed. Oh no, it won't. Okay, great. Yeah, I mean, they left many things out of the story, so there are not many story-related things in the early Harry Potter games, especially not in the PC games. I mean, there's slightly more content than in the movies in some regards, because there are things that the movies skip. Oh, I need a spin. Dang it. There's things that the movies skip and... Oh, one? That's cheating, he teleported. That's cheating. So, yeah, there were some things in the games that the movies left out that were taken from the books. And now we have two auto-scrollers in one level. Yay. This is gonna be fun. So the first is this kind of... I don't know what this is, Ape Escape or whatever. Backwards Escape Wheel Simulator. It's not much to say, which of course wants to collect the beans, which I do anyway, even in any percent, because the beans mark a pretty good route where you have to go to not die. I missed the bean! Come on! May have left things out of the game, but how much compared to the game? That's hard to say, because the games are pretty much stripped of the story in many ways. But there's still things that are in the books, but not that are in the games, taken from the books, that are not in the movies. So it's kind of, I don't know. The problem is, when you talk about the PlayStation games, I would say, okay, they add more. They have more content than the movies do. But when you compare the PC games, it's kind of hard, because they are pretty different, I'd say. I mean, there's not much story, so the gameplay is often not story related. It's just doing classes most of the time. There's some story levels, but really not many. And of course some in the end, like this one here. But yeah, most of the story is just told over cutscenes, via cutscenes. By cutscenes, that's what I wanted to say, I guess. Yes, and that's also what Adam said. That's the problem with these licensed soft turning movie into games. Problem is, of course, they have the schedule, they have to be finished when the movie comes out. And I think if you get access a little bit to the old dev files, or if you search the code a little bit, you get many hints of things that were planned but had to be left out in the game in the end.
Hermione, are you alright? Thanks for saving me. Is he dead?
I think he's just been knocked out.
Well, there's the excuse for HP2 is equally valid as for HP1, because if you compare those games, I mean, despite sharing the same engine, they don't change much. they don't share much. That's what I meant. They don't really compare to each other. The use of the engine is completely different. The levels are completely different. The mechanics, the physics are different.
Welcome to Quidditch. I'm your commentator, Lee Jordan.
Yeah, nice sound back there. So it's actually kind of nice. They could have said, yeah, we do the exact same thing, just in a new story. But now the mechanics are actually entirely different from game to game, which is kind of nice. Yeah, there's a lot of improvement from HP1 to HP2. What I find weird in HP2, for example, is, well, first these cutscenes that seem kind of boring, I think, in HP2. And the second thing Ah, forgot it. What did I want to say? Oh yeah, the mobs. There are so much more creatures in HP2 than HP1, and sometimes it's just a mess. You have entire hallways in certain levels full of creatures, and they're like, why are there so many of them? And like, I think this is what made this game so hard for me as a child, because there were enemies basically everywhere. Yeah, props to Noronda here, not to EA. EA just had the license, basically.
Harry tried on the cloak, while Ron and Hermione helped to prepare for the climb up the tower. Be careful, Harry, said Hermione. You can't stay invisible while you cast spells. Filch might see you.
So, this is now the most
with Norbert safely bundled up,
fun
set off for the tallest
levels.
He hoped that the cloak
so apparently the HP1 PC game revolves much about Norbert, the Norwegian witchback. And so what we have to do now, after we got the 5 seats for him, we have to kinda walk around Filch in disguise, or jump around Filch, grab the safe book here, to escape, to bring Norbert up to the astronomy tower. To rescue him and to give him away, because Hagrid can't keep him. Retak, whoever made HP4 game needs slapping. I don't know what went wrong in the mines. Like, hey, we have a good concept, let's make something completely different that makes no sense and brings no joy whatsoever. And also in a terrible execution. Why not?
I'll catch you. Yes, I will.
This terrible AI, dumb, dull, probing graphics. I don't know. This weird card system, which could have been a nice idea, but it doesn't really enrich the game. Like, the execution is the problem. Again. So, you just have to walk a little bit around Filch, trick him a little bit. The good thing is, which, what we have to keep in mind, he can't hear us when we are on carpet. He can hear us pretty good. We are invisible by now, so it's all about hearing. He can hear us pretty good when we are on wood. So we kind of have to make sure that we are on carpet most of the time. I'm really short on beans. I should go for... Oh my god, I forgot to cast here, dang it. Ah, this is the time loss. Ah, whatever. So I like to go slow here to not get caught by Filch. You can kinda skip him with tricky movement and get this done a little bit quicker, but it's really hard and precise. And if you mess it up, you have to do the entire room again. This is the worst room regarding speedrunning the entire game, because this room is full of backtracking back and forth, and there's no safe cup in there's no safe book in this room, just at before the beginning of it. So yeah, you don't want to mess up this room and lose all the time. What, you don't like the part of the movie Harry wants to vote, collect cards and glitches and save through dungeons? What? This is the best part in the movie. Well, the best part is of course the solid ice slide. But we are finally done with this room, or at least always. So we have to bring, like I said, our mission is to bring up the dragon up the tower. Glitch yourself a little bit to skip a little bit of things. Hello? Harry, please. I know you are first here, but please. Don't make this harder than it has to be. So, this is actually not really necessary to cast this gargoyle, but it makes this whole section much easier. Oh, this was not... Okay. I think you know what I want to do here, but yeah, I kind of failed it. Let's try this again. I think I will fail it again, won't I? Yes, I will. I will fail it again. Okay, okay. Focus. Focus, Roman. Focus. Yeah, there we go. What? Harry? Harry? Hey, please. Can you please do the thing? Please do the thing, Harry. Thank you so much, Harry. You are the best. And no, we are falling down! Ah, doesn't matter. There's a wizard card here, yay! This is PC. Or are you talking about the new game that will come out, this RPG? Someone told me it would be Xbox inclusive, exclusive, but I don't know. I hope it's not, because I only own a PC. And I kinda want to at least test it. So, we gotta do the same thing that we failed 3 times in a row, again. I hope it works a little bit better this time. And hello? Of course not. Ah, come on, Harry. Please. This seems to work, right? Yeah, this works. Thank you so much. I think I'm gonna get some extra beans here. So Noah should be good. And now we're bringing up... No! No 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 no! As I said, everybody loves fridge levels. okay, let's try this again. So, this entire upper part is normally awful, but thankfully we can skip it. And normally we can skip it without dying, and Harry. Please learn to boost. You learned this in your first year, Harry, please. And now you can do this. Believe in you! I believe in you! Boost for your life! No! Please, Harry, please, please, please do the thing. This is it, right? Harry, you can do it. Yes, Harry, good boy. Whew, we finally made it to the end. Great, great. X-Bone and Windows 10. No, I actually don't remember this. Arranged to collect the dragon from the tower. So this thing was not really in the book or in the movie or whatever. Now we have brought him up. We also have to bring him down. I know we don't have to bring him down, but we have to bring ourselves down without being seen. This is a fun level. Hi, Mrs. Norris. We can cast Incendio on Mrs. Norris. I have no idea why, but it's fun, right? Burning Mrs. Norris with a burning spell that actually doesn't burn things, but only lets you knock out plants, and apparently having a little fun with Mrs. Norris. So this level is neither in the movies nor in the books, and it's the longest level in... and the speedrun, yeah. Because there's so many cutscenes that we can't skip. Gameplay wise it's pretty short, there are just a few levels. Here's one, we can skip the entire level by luring Filch a little bit, walking around this bookcase, and now the exit is free! Hey! Normally we should have casted at a bookshelf and jumped around the bookshelves and everything. So, I will collect the safe book for safety reasons. We can skip this entire big room that contains four smaller rooms, actually, by just going over here. Hello. And just skipping most of the level. I will now attend a risky strat. So this is Nick, we just skipped the cutscene with him. Let's see if we can do this. No, we can't. Okay, once again. Yes, we can. Just a little corner jump, nothing big. It's just bad when you mess it up. Enter this cutscene backwards, because now we have the mirror in the hangup. Let the gore of long cutscenes begin. I'm having a little drink in the meantime, there's not much I can do. James and Lily Potter. So how is everybody doing in the awesome Potterthon chat? He was startled when a voice sounded behind him. Maybe I can say some words to this Potterthon, but I can't really say much. I mean, what are we doing? We are speedrunning some fun Harry Potter games back to back, like I think about 20, even a bit more, with the recent changes. With a lot of runners. And yeah, we're doing all this all for fun, of course, but also for charity. All the donations go 100% to Lumos, which is a foundation founded by J.K. Rowling. And I used to know what it was about. So maybe someone can help me out there. So if you have some leftover euros, dollars, yen, whatever. Oh, yeah. Don't hesitate to spend them. So we saw Nick standing there, that's that's because we confused him a little bit, I think. So first we didn't trigger him, but met him later on the course than we normally would. And then we just skipped around him in a way that he didn't predict. And now he just stands there like, what happened? Someone got past me. I don't know. He actually can't see us. Because he's a ghost, I guess. Thank you, Emily, finally. I failed it anyways. Wait, what? I didn't say that. You said that. So we can do this fun little backward animation thingy again to shorten the cutscene a little bit. Staying awake until after HP 200, wow, then you will be in for a long ride, Aiden. So we have to do this little puzzle to lift the weights. Oh, I'm sorry, from the store. And we do this by cleverly outmaneuvering Mrs. Norris. And Filch. So the rule is here basically stay as far away from the block as possible by still reaching the platform, and then go away from the center backwards to avoid them. So the cat movement is kinda RNG, and it's pretty bad RNG right now. Could you please, Mrs. Norris, could you please, thank you so much. Thank you so much. You are a kind cat. You deserve some kitty treats, I guess. The stream might have broken for a second because my internet connection is terrible sometimes, like right now.
Where is he? Pray I don't find you, my stealthy little student.
Gesundheit. Dankeschön. Thank you so much. Raman feeds kids stop running. Yeah, I'm having problems right now. I'm sorry for that. Yeah, it's my feed. I hope it gets better. I don't know what's going on. Nobody else is using the Wi-Fi right now. We just distract Mrs. Norris here a little bit, who keeps guarding the door. Enter the next cutscene backwards. Look who is here again. Oh, yeah, the internet's back to normal. We might have a slight delay by now, but it's back to normal. Yay! Great. So, yeah. These are Fred and George, and we follow them to the secret lair. The thing is, because we entered the previous cutscene backwards, yeah, this happens because the movement in the next cutscene gets a little bit messed up, and one of the twins gets a little bit stuck and steps on Harry's head, who gets hurt. This normally doesn't happen. This only happens if you enter the previous cutscene backwards to mess up camera movement and timing. No, I'm lagging. That happens. It should be good from now on, time and tight.
Hey Harry, do you have 25 beans for us?
Yes indeed I have.
That's it! That's all the beans we need! Thanks Harry, we couldn't have done it without you. Here's a wizard card for you.
Wait. Oh, oh my god, I thought I had forgotten a bean, but I didn't.
Thanks Harry.
Phew! I really thought I'd forgotten a bean. This would have been bad. Glad I got this one. Phew. So we have exactly 250 beans now, and if you remember, this is the exact requirement that we need at the end. And the reason why it's so important is because we just went past the last bean in the entire game. There are no more beans. This is only the endgame left. Yes. There's so far, so long with how accurate this game is to the story. We've just surpassed this thing with the dragon and all, and now we just head to the very end game on the third floor. And there are no beans on the third floor. I mean, why would there be, right? A long cutscene ahead. So if everything goes right, the one will last for about, I think, 12 minutes, I'd say, yeah.
Anyone would want it, said Harry.
Maybe a little bit less.
Hermione suspected that the package Hagrid had taken from Gringotts.
I hope I didn't overlook a card. I should have 23 cards by now, because there's only one card lying around, and then there's the last card we get at the very end.
Snape's been acting very suspicious lately. He may be planning to steal the Sorcerer's Stone.
But there's no way Snape would try anything while Dumbledore's around.
But Dumbledore left 10 minutes ago for the Ministry of Magic in London.
That must mean that tonight's the night. Let's go!
Remember guys, tonight's the night. Tonight is the night of Potterthorn, I guess.
What about Filch? He's always watching the Forbidden Corridor.
We'll just have to take our chances then.
Cutscene, 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 like we said. Like I said, we can't speed this up in any way or skip this or whatever. And
come on,
now we
go.
Can finally move. And there's a chest, I wonder what's inside. Look at this, it's card number 24. I think I didn't quite explain this. I'm standing on the edge of the chest because therefore I get the card stuck in the chest and can directly pick it up. The problem is normally it would jump out of the chest and then it takes like 5 seconds or so until it lands down, and then I can pick it up. So this wastes a lot of time. So I don't want to have the card jump out of the chest. Definitely not.
I don't think we should go in there.
So.
But we've got to stop Snape.
This is Hagrid's little pet dog, Fluffy, that we are facing now. And because we entered the cutscene with Fluffy backwards, we can move much earlier than we normally would, skipping two dialogue lines. So the way this works, we kind of have to figure out which of the dog has which duration length that takes him to fall asleep. So we do the longest first, then we do the medium one. And the reason is, it also takes them this amount of time to wake up again. Like, in the middle, this one takes the longest, the one on the right takes a little bit shorter, and the one on the left, in this case, takes the shortest to wake up. So it's important to do it in the right order, to not have to let them wake up again, because the times. And yeah, the problem is the order's RNG, so you have to test out first which is the longest, which is the medium, and which has the shortest time to be fallen asleep. And in this case I was lucky because I got the longest head, I'd call him first, and the medium second, and the shortest third. What is this called? Hermione, what is this called? It's a devil's snare. Okay, I get it. Okay, this is kind of a no-brainer, even casual. We just cast a few times at Hermione, then we go over to Ron, and we cast a few times at Ron. And then we are done. I'm abusing physics all the time, kinda. So this is kinda accurate to the book, this endgame. Now we have the thing with the ring key, which surprisingly has the same shape as a snitch. What? No, that was not good, that was not good. Because this key can be really nasty. You see, it can be very nasty, this takes way too long. Now we got him. So from here on it's basically just any percent, we just go through the final levels. And that's it. And now for the chess game that doesn't really work like ordinary chess. And also, it's strictly scripted, so it's always the same every time. So it's literally a no-brainer. We can get Hermione stuck here, which confuses the cutscene. So normally Hermione should be here too in the cutscene, but she isn't. So the game just shows an empty space where Hermione should be standing. Hello, Hermione. Welcome back to chat. So, as I said, this is all scripted. And like Hermione said, the figures move one field at a time. And that's basically the idea. They move one tile towards us. And when they meet each other, that is for each other. It has absolutely no meaning whether the figure is white or whether it's black. Like it should be in real life. Oh, Hermione. Struggle to read text in dark mode. Yeah, especially Whip's name. And yeah, 4 moves and we are done. This is the quickest way to solve this. And now we go for the final thing that got completely left out in the movie. It's the potions. And like in the movie, we skip this one as well because we are speedrunners, right? I tried to do some neat jumps here, but I failed a little bit. Ah, whatever. So this is the potions room. It's like one of these gambling games where you have to guess the right bottle. They move around and then you kind of have to guess it. We just skip it with the wall walk and yeah, that was it with the potions room. We can skip a cutscene here. That's why I walk over here, that's important. Collect the safe book for safety. Do safe jumps here. And now we can face Snape, finally. There he stands! Oh, we are trapped. Oh my god. That isn't Snape? This isn't Snape. I thought it was Snape. I thought Snape was the main villain.
You're far too inquisitive to remain among the living.
But it was Quirrell! It was Quirrell all along! Yeah. Glad we have a nice little brightness boost. And yeah. Our only goal was to avoid his attacks and to reach the end, and we just did this pretty quick, I'd say. I need a chocolate frog, maybe two, just to be sure. And now for the final fight against Voldemort. If you hold forward at a specific point, a part of the cutscene gets skipped for some reason, I don't know why. Maybe Harry gains movement for a short moment. Like right there, we just skipped like 1 or 2 seconds of dialogue lines. Yeah, this fight is completely scripted, so you can get ready on time in about a minute. You just let him be buried by the column, then he gets his own attacks gets reflected at the mirror. We do the same thing mirrored, we destroy this column onto him and move just like that he kills himself with his own spell. Now phase 1 is gone, all the pillars are destroyed. Phase 2 is he kinda changes between long casts and the spam casts. And his long casts we have to avoid normally, and the spam casts, these are the ones that can get reflected by the mirror, that's what we do here. But of course it's faster than to avoid them is to just get hurt. Because then the attack stops quickest when we just walk in front of him and let us get be hurt. That's why it's important to have full health and get ready on time. He is only 1 hit point left. If his health bar is down, it's over. Get ready, on. Time! That was it. Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, or rather to say, Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. And hopefully all wizard cards. Let's wait for the final cutscene.
Dumbledore smiled. What happened down in the dungeons between yourself and Professor Quirrell is a complete secret, he said. So naturally, the whole school knows. The stone had been destroyed. But Harry remained fearful that
because if we have done everything right, we get an additional cutscene coming up soon.
Nevertheless, Harry, if our battles do no more than slow Voldemort's return, with luck he may never regain his power at all.
And this is the additional cutscene. This means we haven't screwed up. We got all the wizard cards, and we got the last one. Who is it? We know this guy.
Wizard's card from his robes, and handed it to Harry. You've got the whole set now, Harry.
Yes, we got all the cards. Our collecting got rewarded. Nice. I think we should just be a little bit ahead of schedule with that.
To celebrate Slytherin winning the House Cup.
And I think we should take the time to watch the screens. 148.29. Okay, it's still a little bit less on my end. It's like a 147, but this is because I got a little bit of stream delay. So yeah, that's fine.
To the team with the most house points. At the moment,
this was a great run. I screwed up at some points. I got some pretty great levels in between.
However, continued Dumbledore,
and as always, no matter how you play this game, it's always Slytherin that is ahead until the very end.
60 points.
And so then in the end, Gryffindor wins the House Cup, just like in the movies. Just like in the books, it's all a scam. No matter how good you are, Slytherin is always ahead, and in the end, Gryffindor wins. So, the question remains, what did we give Fred and George all these beans for? There we go. And everybody's happy. Yay. At least Fred and George are. What do we get now? We got a pretty glitched menu now. of course. With all the cards. Isn't that amazing? We got all the cards. With Harry Potter. This is what you always get shown last. So this is interesting. Even if you if you finish this game the first time, you get shown the screen with Folio Magia, and then you see, oh, this is empty, and there are many empty spots, and you're like, dang it! I have to play this game again! to get all the cards! So this is like, this has to be the true ending, right? So this is it. All I can do is press escape to actually finish this game and trigger the final cutscenes. And see all the beautiful names that have taken part into the development of this game. And yeah, I guess that's from me. I'm gonna head out. I don't know how to, I'm not too sure how to do it. I think Luigi will just cut me off. But yeah, that's from me.